Hey, come over here. I need some assistance taking out this opponent.
Drag and drop the Silent Wave faction card from the bottom left onto the...
Survive the streets of Novus, you must learn quickly. Let's run a machine simulation. Every match begins with 6 community cards. Each card has a value and community sector. If you have any issues... In this simulation, the machine is making the first move. Let's see what it does. The machine took the underground 8, and now the score is 0 to 8. You can see the scores at the top of the screen on the left and the right. A new card has been drawn to the board. This is called the end of turn card, and it will be drawn once a turn has been completed. It's your turn to go. You score points on the left side of the board, so the left side is yours. The right, at the start of every turn, you choose one card from the center of the board, known as the neutral area. This will be your starting card. Choose one now and try to get a higher score. You moved a card to your allies row. Doing that locks the card in place and it can never be touched again. You must select the starting card from the neutral area, which is the center of the board, at the beginning of every turn. Your score is the sum of all card values on your side of the board. Whichever player has the highest score at the end of all rounds wins the match. After choosing your starting card and placing it in its starting location, it may move other cards on the board. Movements on your starting card tell you the communities of the card it moves. Direction of the movement, positive, or the plus sign, means towards your side, while negative, or the minus sign, means away from you, and how many rows it moves the card in that direction. For example, if you have a law enforcer movement on your starting card, it would move the law enforcer plus one row to your recruits row. Go ahead and choose your starting card. Once your starting card has been selected, all movements must be completed if possible. Remember, the plus sign is towards you, the minus is away from you. You may skip movements if that community is not in play or cannot be moved. Your turn is ended, and an end-of-turn card has been added. At the start of every turn, there must be at least 3 cards in the neutral area. 2 more cards have been added to take care of that. The machine chose a card with a union, religion, and law enforcer. You have a law enforcer on your side. It's taken the law enforcer from you. There go your points. Try to use that same strategy against it if you can. There are new icons showing on these cards. They're called draw icons. It's your turn again. Remember to check all the movements on the possible starting cards to maximize your move. If you choose a card without any movements, you don't get to move anything else. You just moved a card with a draw icon on it. Any card moved out of the neutral area with these icons will draw a card for each icon moved. This happens after the move phase has ended. To complete the move phase, you must complete all possible movements on your starting card. These movements can affect cards anywhere in play, as long as they are not protected. Since four draw icons in total were moved out of the neutral area, four new cards will be drawn to the board. As always, one additional card is drawn to mark the end of your turn. Let's see if you can finish the job. Try and beat the machine. Remember, starting cards can only be chosen from the neutral area. Movements of the starting card you chose